And we will continue to update that story for folks throughout the morning. But we're going to switch gears right now at 7:47 and talk about allergies. We've been waiting a while for spring weather, and it is finally here. But again, so are the spring allergies big time. Dr. Scott Phillips is here with more on what we can do about them. Nice to see you.
It's great to see you too, Angela.
I've been getting lots of questions in the last week saying, what is going on? What is going on?
The trees are pollinating now, and you see the leaves coming out, and so does their pollen. So people are really starting to suffer with tree allergies.
So tree allergies mainly. Mm-hmm. Let's talk about what we can do as we start feeling really sick and under the weather.
Well, you're right. There are a lot of things you can buy over the counter that are allergy medicines, but when you need a little help, go see your doctor. We've got a lot of different sprays, we've got different pills, and we've also got allergy shots and some other alternatives if you need them.
Let's talk specifically about that, because a lot of people have the perception that if you're really going to deal with severe allergies, you have to go once a week and get a shot. That is not necessarily the case.
Not anymore. In fact, we now have allergy drops, which you place underneath your tongue, and although you do them every day instead of once a week like you would the shots, you do them at home, and they're also considered much safer.
For the kids, can you think about that, parents at home? A drop Absolutely. Under the tongue or something and not have to go to the doctor, not have to worry about the needles?
Needles are never popular, but especially with the kids, so it opens up a whole new avenue of things that we can do for allergies here.
Let's talk quickly about the testing, too. Is it easy?
Testing is very easy. In fact, I can show you right on your arm right here. All you do is you have a little pricker. We take it and we push it down like that, and now you've been tested for allergies.
Nice. You barely feel it, really.
People think it's painful and so forth. It's really a lot easier than what you think.
That was, I didn't even flinch. Let's talk about, these are over-the-counter.
No, these are all prescription ones, except for the Zyrtec here, which has been over-the-counter recently.
Yeah.
And we also have something else, which is saline that you can use for your nose. This is the Neti Pot, made popular by Oprah, as well as a little irrigation kit. Washes the allergens out of the nose and gives people temporary relief.
We're hearing more about that, too, mm-hmm. about flushing and is that something that you really believe in?
Absolutely. It's one of the best medicines, if you will, that you can actually use for your nose. It's very safe, and it is effective, and it causes no harm whatsoever.
And really quickly, too, about prescription, is it really just depend on the allergy and the person, or is there something that you feel like kind of works better than a lot of things?
Boy, if there was one thing that worked for everybody, it'd be the only thing on the market, but people are like a combination lock. You have to keep working with them until you find the right combination for them.
Dr. Phillips, how do we get in contact with you if we need help?
You're welcome to email me at centadocs.com, or you can call your family practice doctor, who can do a lot for you, and then send you on to a specialist if you need it.
If they need the specialist. As always, we appreciate it. A lot of people affected by this right now. All right, thank you. 7:49, a lot of people affected by the traffic this morning. Bill, is it slowing down or picking up?
Yeah, it kind of depends on where you're at. And once again, Angela, still folks on a spring break mode for at least a good portion of it.